other little chorus that we've been singing is our mission song. We'd like to sing that again tonight, and you remember now it begins, our mission is here, our mission is clear, our mission to learn and live God's way. That's the first part of it. The little tune sounds like this. Our mission is here, our mission is clear, our mission to learn and live God's way. Together we sing, together we pray, together we hear God's word each day. Together we sing, together we pray, together we by God always. Our mission is here, our mission is here, our mission is clear, our mission to learn and live God's. All right, let's all sing together, and if you want to come in on the echo, do that. Particularly, maybe the choir could do it. We'll sing, our mission is here, our mission is here. Here we go. Our mission is here, our mission is clear, our mission to learn and live God's way. Together we sing, together we pray, together we hear God's word each day. Together we sing, together we pray, together we glorify God always. Our mission is here, our mission is clear, our mission to learn and live God's way. Let's turn in our hymn books now to number 26. And if you haven't been able to follow because you didn't know the notes or something, now you can sing because we're going to look to the books. Number 26, Send the Light. All you men, come in on your parts on it. Second stanza. First stanza, you can all practice up.
Glory to near my God's day. Just sing this very reverently and so we can hear ourselves sing now. Just hum that through once more in preparation for our prayer of the evening. We'll all stand and hum this great hymn through together, thinking of the words as we hum.
A pastor of the Thankful Baptist Memorial Church will lead us in prayer.
Let us pray. Almighty God, our most holy and eternal Father, who art of purer eyes than to behold evil, let thy gracious spirit descend upon us this evening. Grant that no impure thoughts may pollute the souls which thou hast set apart for thyself, that no unclean words may defile the lips which thou hast consecrated to be organs of thy praise, that no unholy acts may desecrate the hearts which thou hast chosen for thy temple. Grant that our souls may be kept for thee, that our lips may be used only in speaking for thee, and that the temples of our hearts may be ever worthy of thine indwelling. O Lord, most mighty, we commend ourselves unto thee, and to the word of thy grace, which is able to build us up and to give us an inheritance among all them that are sanctified. We beseech thee to keep our souls from death, our eyes from tears, our feet from falling, that we may walk before thee in the land of the living, and that the glorious appearing of thy Son, our Lord, may be presented faultless before the presence of thy glory with exceeding joy. Through the same Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
This evening, we have only a few announcements to make. One of the most interesting beginnings is the fact that we have with us tonight our own city commission, which was so thoughtful to postpone its meeting tonight. And I would appreciate the members of the city commission who are in the center section to rise for just a moment, please. Thank you. As all of you know, tomorrow brings to a close the series of noonday messages which have been brought this week by Dr. Charles Welburn. Tomorrow will be the last day. And I am sure a great many of you know also that over station WETB, every afternoon between 4:30 and 5, this message is rebroadcast. Also, each morning, as a reminder, I would like to call to your attention the fact that Mr. and Mrs. Dean Jacoby are on station WJHL-TV each morning at 9 o'clock. That gives you ample time to get the dishes washed and then sit down quietly while the men are working. The speakers for tomorrow night are Dr. James DeForest Murch, managing editor of Christianity Today and a minister of the Christian Church. And the second speaker tomorrow night is Dr. Pierce Harris, who is known to so many of you, pastor of the First Methodist Church of Atlanta, Georgia. Tonight, Dr. Bill Steele, pastor of Munsey Memorial Methodist Church, is going to explain the decision cards. Dr. Steele.
Thank you, Dr. Charlie. Let the ushers come forward, please, with the cards. It is not our purpose to talk about these cards or explain these cards now. We simply want to get them into your hands so that you may hold them, you may look at them, you may think about them. And during the addresses by our men tonight, if you feel some challenge and if you feel that God speaks to you, we want you to record it on that card. Will you take the card, please? Put it in your pocket or hold it in your hand until after both of our men have spoken tonight, and we will give you further direction.
We have a real treat tonight in the special music, which is under the direction of Mrs. Ruth Watts. She is going to lead the East Tennessee State College Choir. Mrs. Watts.